Good morning, everyone, and welcome to all of you present and online for this service as we gather together and bid farewell to our incredibly loved Carolina. A special welcome to her parents and sister, niece and nephew, Marie, Stian, and Michaela, her niece and nephew joining us online from Switzerland. My name is Ellen Fischett, and I'm a friend of Carolina's. We met through our shared love for empowerment of women in science, technology, engineering, and maths through a nonprofit organization, Inspiring 50 South Africa. Some housekeeping rules and messages before we commence. So outside of the chapel, down the hallway to on my right, you will find the bathrooms. The service will include blessings from six different religions. Her eulogy was written by Neeruj and will be read by Delia, and a special message from her parents and sister will be shared then. Kevin will share his farewell message. After thanks are given by Nikki, the family will leave the room with Carolina and Berlioz and taken to the acclimation chamber at 11:15. I would then like to ask the remaining friends and family to move to the tea room on my right-hand side, where tea will be served and some beautiful snacks. And because of Carolina's love for music, we ask that you feel free to sing songs in tribute and celebration of Carolina's life. The acclimation will be completed by 12 o'clock, and you're most welcome to connect with each other and to smile and laugh, because that's what she did a lot of. And then to join us at 10 Barlin Road, Marina da Gama, for a light lunch, generously and lovingly prepared by Mrs. Govender, Kevin's mother, and Carolina's mother-in-law. And now back to the service. Carolina was known for being this luminous wherever she was and by whoever met her. In the true spirit of Carolina's incredible love for the people that she met and that she knew, we are starting the ceremony with words of blessings from the six different religions I refer to. Carolina did not actively practice any specific religion, except the love of all things human and living, but had a deep respect for the faith of her loved ones. To honor her wish and that all religions and people are included and embraced in the service of celebrating her life, we have asked people close to her to share blessings. Please note that the blessings are shared in no particular order. And first of all, I would like to call up Reggie Machu. Welcome.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Reggie Majo, and I've been blessed to be one of Carolina's colleagues at the University of the Western Cape, Department of Physics and Astronomy. And indeed, she was a person of light and ray that brought such a lot of sunshine in everybody's life. And our deepest and sincere condolences to Kevin and the boys and the family and all the good friends from far away. Let us pray. Our loving and parent God, we thank you that we can call upon your loving name during our time of intense pain and sorrow for the passing of your beloved servant, Carolina Ödman. Thank you, God, for blessing us with a true, sincere, and genuine living angel that exuded so much of your love and your grace to all that she came in contact with. Thank you, Lord, for blessing her parents with such a loving and beautiful daughter and also a sister in the extended family. And we pray especially for them that's far away, that through your Holy Spirit, your shalom, your peace will be with all of them. Thank you, Lord, that you've blessed Kevin with such a super loving and beautiful wife. And Lord, like he stated now the other day, Lord, when we asked him, do you have enough memories? He said, I don't have memories for one lifetime, but I've got beautiful memories of several lifetimes. So Lord, we pray especially for him that will have this immense task of raising Karina's beautiful boys. Lord, we pray that you'll just guide him with Holy Spirit wisdom in everything that he'll do, that he'll just feel your closeness even guiding him in whatever we do. Lord, we pray for Xavier and Cyprian, and we thank you that Karina has been such a wonderful mother like none other. Lord, we pray that you'll be with them while they're growing up, that her memories will constantly guide them in everything that they'll do, that they'll feel her presence continuously, even as long as they live. Lord, we pray for family and extended friends. The circle is big, Lord, and we pray that you'll just be with all of them. We thank you that you've blessed the world, her lifelong friends, her work colleagues, and everybody that became like family to her. Thank you that you've blessed Africa with such a beautiful soul, and that she's leaving a part of herself, especially on our loving continent. Lord, thank you that you touched so many lives. Whether one drives past security gates, they'll ask, where is that woman with that amazing, loving smile? Lord, whether it's the people that came in and cleaned the offices, we were also shocked because her love just transcended everybody that she came in contact with, all the way up to the professors, Lord, the vice chancellors, the ministers. Lord, she had no favoritism, and we thank you for that. Lord, as Nikki stated earlier, she lived that word. Lord, she made love a verb. And Lord, in your word, 1 Corinthians 13 states that love is patient, love is kind, love does not envy, love does not boast, love is not proud, love does not dishonor others, love is not self-seeking, love is not angered, love keeps no record of wrongs, love does not delight in evil, and it always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, and it always perseveres, and it never fails. And Lord, she lived that love. She made us all realize that we're so much more, and we've got such a lot to give to the world. And Lord, help us to live that legacy that she left behind, that we should just love each other. Lord, we pray that your infinite and your perpetual light will always shine on Carolina. O God of infinite compassion, we pray that you look in love and pity on especially Kevin and the close-knit family, Xavier and Cyprian. Lord, that they'll always feel your presence. Lord, be their support, their strength, and their shield, that they may always just trust in you and know that you're always there, and that Carolina always will be there with them. Lord, we also know that in Romans 8, verse 35, it says indeed that if God is for us, who can be against us? And thank you that you've blessed us with that living, beautiful angel. And we know that you'll always be, especially with Kevin and the boys and the extended family. And we pray this in your name. Amen.
Thank you, Reggie. I now wish to call up Mr. and Mrs. Govender, Rose and Sunny Govender, to say your blessings for Carolina.
So thank you, everyone, for listening to this, having patiently. It was slightly longer than I expected. My name is Marajit Triambak. I'm also from UWC. And I was requested by Mrs. Govinder to give some context to these two prayers that she selected for her daughter-in-law. The first invocation was to Lord Shiva, and is particularly dear to the family because of its close, almost palpable association with Carolina and the relationship she had with her mother-in-law. The second hymn is the Gayatri Mantra, which is a universal prayer in India that dates back to around 1500 BC. And I was requested by Mrs. Govinder to read out a general translation of the mantra at the end of the puja, which I will do so now. We meditate on the glory of the Creator who has produced this universe, who is the embodiment of knowledge and light, who is the remover of sin and ignorance. May your divine light enlighten our minds and illuminate all realms of our being, physical, mental, and spiritual. Please expel any darkness from our hearts and bestow upon us the knowledge. Thank you.
Thank you for that, Mr. and Mrs. Govinder. I'd now like to call up Islam Hussein.
So my name is Islam, and I used to work on the Prof. Carolina at IDEA. Is that okay? Should I make it? Okay, this is better, I think. So my name is Islam, and I used to work on the Prof. as a data scientist. She was amazing. I won't take long. I'm not very good at public speaking. So I'm sure this is a very difficult situation for all of us. So I pray to Allah that He will give us the strength and the patience to deal with this situation, especially for Kevin and their families. Ameen. Thanks.
I'm not as tall as you, Islam. Thank you for that. I'd now like to call up a colleague of Carolina's as well, Siambonga. May I welcome you up, please?
Good morning, everyone. My name is Siyambonga Machaule. I'm a colleague of Carolina. I'm here to represent the African spirituality. And in essence, when we deal with death in African religion, death is not just the end, but rather a transition to a new life. And therefore, our duty today is to celebrate Carolina's life, to thank her for sharing her life with us, to thank her ancestors for giving her to us. And therefore, what I'll do now, which is a prayer that I'll conduct in this Xhosa, I will essentially connect to my ancestors, to ask them to connect me to her ancestors and that of her loved ones, and that she may get blessings as she enters into this new journey, and that even though we are saddened of her departure, but we are comforted that she's no longer in pain and that she has now found peace. And we will ask that the loved ones who remain behind, even though it will be difficult, that we find strength and we hold on to the memories we held of her, and that we may continue to live life in the way that she would have hoped for us. And therefore, I'll start by reciting my clan names and then ask for permission for me to perform this prayer. Kumdali wento zonke. Camaku Sheko Bella Umpulano Pansaben Lung and Dulan. All such as his Galas Bethum. Camaku Shon and Elo Gomos Bumf. Oka Jin, Amanuab, Apo Mamas Rakon. Yatella Gamanyanga Gucci Banduadal. Kuzo Zongan Dawnekus, Ubani Nigelemfum, Yugban, the Tandas Lum Shabuam, Nanjo and Yelis Zilikai. Into one of the ones alum savings. The Akalagan would need Pamand, Ugban and Dumtana Zelens, the Tet and I, Dimdige, Lumtana Zuam. Carolina, I'm challenging Stigans Wangue, Sizzes, when Gizzes. Sitagans Wangue, Sitanagi, Tegile, Uguamba Guaco. See Akalagan Domazan. Siyacela ngentokazi yakwa Governor nakwa Ödman ukuthi uzungakhathazeki kakhulu koko ze amaweni odata omkhulu omakhulu nabantu kweni abakwelela imoya bakwamkela bakhusela bayenze indlela yakho ibenhle uzuthi ke xa kufika ixesha ukwazi ubuya ukuthi usesinyanye sihle ukhusela nalo usapho lwakho ukhusela abo bakuthandayo ukhusele nathi thina besebenza nawe ze kuthi xa kunzima sikwazi ukubambelela kwezankumbulo zakho ngiyacela ke namhlanje into yokubana izindlela yakho ibenhle uyohlala kule mimoya ubabalisele ngengxaki sidwana nazo kulo mhlaba usicelele into yokuba masijongane usicelele into yokuba masikwazi ukujongana nesi sifo sithe sakubeka apha namhlanje siyacela ke kuqamathi siyacela kumanye kamakhulu ukuthi agcine usapho alubambe lukwazi ukukhulisa nawo abafana bebabini uzube naye uKevin akwazi ukubamba usapho lwakhe ndiyacela ndiyacamagushe ndiyacela xa nditshoyo ndiyacela kobhedla ompulano obhakisa benontolwane ukuthi azabe nami kudede ubumnyama kuvele ubukhanya endleleni kaCaroline camaku.
Thank you.
Beautiful words and prayers and blessings, Carolina, I know, is smiling. I would now like to call up Amanda to please come and say your psalm. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Amanda. And it's very hard to summarize how I knew Carolina. She was a one-of-a-kind person who moved and created many circles around her. And for me, she was a mentor. Of course, she was a friend and a guide and role model. And we had a huge amount in common, including our love of the universe, of discovery, of all the little creatures we could find everywhere. We both always needed to be near water, had an affection for extremely kind, lovely husbands. But most of all, it was our shared awe that we both had for our four boys and eventually little girl. I'm going to say for you the two Jewish prayers that are usually said at a funeral, and I will say them in both Hebrew and in English so that they are understood, I guess, on all levels. El Male Rachamim, Shochen Bamromim, Hamet Samanuchanochona, Al Kanfe Hashkina, Bamalot Kedoshim, Utahorim, Kazohar, Harakia Mazhirim, Et Nishmat Carolina, Bat Sven, Vemari, Eshet Kevin, Vem Xavier Vesiprian, Shalchalo Alama, Bavosha Niva Kolki Hilataze, Yiten Stakaba Adhas Karat Nishmata, Bagana Den Tehe Menucha. Menuchata, Lachen Baal Harachamim, Yastira, Beseter Kanfav Laolamim, Vietzror Betzror Hachayim et Nishmat, Adonai Hu Nachlata, Vetanuach Beshalom, Almishkana, Venomar, Amen. O God, full of mercy, who dwells on high, grant proper rest on the wings of the Divine Presence, in the lofty levels of the holy and the pure ones, who shine like the glow of the firmament for the soul of Carolina, the daughter of Sven and Marie, the wife of Kevin, and the mother of Xavier and Cyprian, who went on to her world, for I and all of this community will contribute to charity in remembrance of her soul. May her resting place be in the Garden of Eden. Therefore, may the Master of Mercy shelter her in the shelter of his wings for eternity, and may he bind her soul in the bond of life. Hashem is her heritage, and may she rest in peace in her resting place. Let us respond, Amen. This last is the prayer that mourners say at a funeral and regularly thereafter. May his great name grow exalted and sanctified in the world that he created as he willed. May he give reign to his kingship in your lifetimes and in your days, and in the lifetimes of the entire family of Israel, swiftly and soon. Now we respond, Amen. May his great name be blessed forever and ever. Blessed, praised, glorified, exalted, extolled, mighty, upraised, and lauded by the name of the Holy One. Blessed is he. Beyond any blessing and soul, praise and consolation that are uttered in the world. Now respond, Amen. May there be abundant peace from heaven and life upon us and upon all Israel. Now respond, Amen. He who makes peace in his heights, may he make peace upon us and upon all. Now respond, Amen. Yitkadal v'yitkadash merabba. Be'almah divrach ritzei v'yamlich malchutzei v'chayechon v'yamechon v'chayedichol beit Yisrael v'agala v'zman kariv v'yimru, Amen. Yehesh merabba mavarach lo'olam olamei olmaya yitparach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnaseh v'yitadar v'yitaleh v'yitalal shmedi kudusha b'richu. לעלם עם כל ברכתה ושירתה, תשבחה ונחמתה, תאמרן בעלמה ואמרו, אמן. יהי שלמה רבה מן שמיה וחיים עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו, אמן.
And I'd now like to call up Michelle Murphy, please. Thank you.
Ram, you're going to time for me, huh? Sure. So I wanted to say thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity. I'm really very honored. I made notes like a Zen Z on my phone, so if you don't mind, I wanted to write it out by hand because it warranted that, but then, yeah. I am Michelle. I had the privilege of meeting Carolina via Kevin when I used to teach yoga to him and his colleagues. And then the circle got bigger from there because then I got to meet his boys and his wife and yeah. So I'm representing the Buddhist faith and if you, yeah, just give me an opportunity to explain at the end. So what I'll do is I'll talk a little bit about my impression of Carolina and then a little bit about the faith itself, the practice. And then at the end, we normally have, there's a few lines that we chant. I would like to explain to you what it means so that you understand, and I'd like to end the little session with that chant, if you don't mind. So with my contribution today, I would explain how we as Buddhists perceive life and death, and how Carolina's all-embracing spirit managed to set an example of having been larger than life. You see, it's not about life expectancy, but about what you expect from life. In Buddhism, we believe death is part of the continuum, I hope I say that correct, and certainly not the end. So my interaction with Carolina is that she was as bright as a star, always dressed in a smile, and most of all, extremely humble. I believe humility is not thinking less of yourself, but humility is thinking about yourself less. So in India, I know that we believe that we are spiritual beings having a physical experience, and I can relate to that. So I don't know how many of you have been to Delhi and had the privilege of visiting the Gandhi Museum. And at the top of the entrance, there's a saying, I'm gonna try and find it now. It says, "My life is my message." And I'll explain why I mention that. There was a journalist that, as Gandhi was boarding a train, and he said, Gandhiji, what is your legacy? You know, what is your message for the world? And Gandhi turned around and he said, my life is my message. And I thought that's really beautiful. So for all of us, and especially with the way that I viewed Carolina, your life is and has to be your message. So when you manage to transcend all of your shortcomings and embrace life like Carolina did, then you will know why you are here. Carolina knew why she was here, as she left a blazing trail, completely present for every moment of her life. She epitomized someone who knew that her only job is to be herself. We are also lucky to have basked in her brightness and in her glow. So thank you. So I'm just going to explain what I'm going to chant now, if you don't mind. And then it's just a short session of doing so. So as Buddhists, we chant Nam Myoho Renge Kyo, and I'll explain to you what each of them means. Nam means to dedicate oneself. To chant Nam Myoho Renge Kyo is an act of faith in the power and possibility inherent in life. Kyo is the teaching of this wondrous law. It also implies a threat, indicating that all of life is one interwoven fabric. So do you see now why life and death is not so different for us? It's just, like the previous gentleman said, it's just an extension. Renge means lotus flower, symbolizing the wonder of this law. We can bring forth this power from within, just as we are, and overcome any challenge. Myo is the mystic law or truth that is the essence of all life. It is the mystic nature of our life with its unfathomable potential. Am I still doing okay? Okay, so now I'm gonna chant. Thanks, Ron. So we normally have these beads, and I got introduced by to Buddhism by astrophysicist friend who worked with Kevin and Aram and Noah. Nam yo ho renge kyo, nam yo ho renge kyo, nam yo ho renge kyo. Nam yo ho renge kyo, 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 ho renge kyo, nam yo 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 ho renge kyo, ge kyo, nam yo ho renge 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 kyo, yo renge kyo, nam yo ho 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 renge kyo, ho renge kyo, nam yo 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 ho renge kyo. Thank you.
Nothing but love, abundance, and blessings for Carolina and the family today and everyone here. I now wish to call up Delia for the reading of a eulogy that was written, co-written by Neeruj. Thank you.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm Delia. Carolina was a beloved colleague and a dear friend. And thanks to Neeruj for having written this beautiful elegy. We've come here together as a large family to bid farewell to our Carolina. When I look at this gathering, I see grief and deep loss. I see an ocean of genuine love, compassion, and empathy. I also see wonder and a sense of gratitude for having had a person like Carolina in our lives. Her professional bio reads, she brings an engineering, problem-solving mind and academic analytical perspective and many years of experience working in the developed and developing world using science and technology to drive growth and development. That's true, but we know this statement hides an ocean of talents. She has always transcended boundaries, forged deep connections between different knowledges and people, and has brought sheer joy and happiness to all our lives. Carolina was born in July 1974 to Maud Marianne Ödman and Sten Erik Ödman in Lausanne, Switzerland, and has a sibling, Michaela Ödman. She went to school at École Primaire d'Aubonne and then the Gymnase de Nyon. Inspired by her high school physics teacher, she decided to pursue a career in the sciences. She then became someone who would herself inspire young people across so many countries to pursue their dreams. Her school days were no less remarkable than her later years. born to a Swedish family living in Switzerland, she could speak Swedish, English, and French fluently. She became adept at playing the harp and the piano, performing ballet, playing golf, skiing really well. Her interest and her skill in all things technical was obvious from an early age. She was part of a local computer club in Aubonne called Ghostbusters that pirated games. And this club was later named Club Informatique du Aubonne, called CIA. Some of her colleagues will recognize where her interest in dot astronomy and hackathons clearly grew from. Carolina then joined the prestigious École Polytechnique Fédérale de Lausanne, EPFL, in Switzerland, for a master's degree in physics engineering from 1993 to 2000. While at EPFL, she joined the Equal Opportunity Office to promote gender equality in scientific careers. At that time, she was interviewed for women's career magazine, and said, "I would like to practice a profession where the human aspect takes precedence over pure theory." And she never disowned this mindset. Her father was reminiscing that when she was at EPFL, she once stepped up to replace a sick vocalist at a rock concert she'd helped organize. Her singing was so amazing that the band offered her a job on the spot. She declined out of respect for the original artist, else she would have been a rock star as well. And I'm sure almost all of us have heard her say to us at some point, "You're a rock star, you're a superstar," when we did something she really liked. So maybe unknowingly she did form that music band after all of us friends and family in it. After EPFL, she worked for 5 months as a research engineer at a medical research center, where she worked on a project modeling blood flow and vascular grafts using fluid dynamic simulations. She was fascinated to know that this work probably had a part to play in developing the Whipple procedure, which she underwent for treating her pancreatic cancer. She then joined the University of Cambridge for a PhD in astronomy, receiving the Isaac Newton Scholarship after her first year. This was also the period where she briefly became a hedgehog foster mom, too. After completing her PhD, she spent a few months in Paris in 2003 as a consultant for UNESCO, preparing for its world report towards knowledge societies. Naroj was going through the report, and some of the topics that struck him were innovation culture, science and society, indigenous knowledge, women in knowledge societies, all themes that we know have remained very close to Carolina's heart since then. She then spent 4 months in Cape Town in 2004 as a tutor at the African Institute for Mathematical Sciences, AIMS, after which she returned to Europe, having been awarded the well-known Marie Curie postdoctoral fellowship, which she did in Rome, Italy. Here she worked on theoretical cosmology, Bayesian statistics, and programming. By then, her interests and talents had vastly outgrown the constraints of mainstream academia. And when she found an advertisement for a position to design and manage a new project on astronomy for young children, she jumped at the chance and moved to Leiden in the Netherlands. This project, Universe Awareness, or UNAWE, was the brainchild of George Miley in Leiden, who had just won a grant to start the program. In his message, George celebrates her enormous enthusiasm for the goals of the program, her exceptional personality that exuded positivity and inspiration, her ability to deal with everyone, her love for children, of animals of all sorts, and our planet as a whole. Carolina once said of UNAWE, "Astronomy is built on a heritage from many cultures. It is built upon things that these children are part of." And she always carried that through her thought with her. Carolina was the international project manager at UNAWE from 2005 to 2010, where she successfully transformed the idea into an active program in over 40 countries. She had been waiting for a project like UNAWE, and UNAWE had been waiting for a project like her. By this time, she was a world expert in astronomy and science and its connections with development, education, and society. She was also looked up to as an exceptional administrator and project manager, and as someone who believed that colleagues can also be your friends. Carolina was universally acclaimed and loved for her ability to transform any idea into an international project with seeming effortlessness, with friends across the globe who loved to work with her. But her love for South Africa and its people had made it obvious that she and her partner Kevin would eventually come together in this country rather than any other in the world. George Miley mentions that, "I'm proud that she met Kevin at a Universe Awareness workshop in Leiden, and I regard their union as one of the most important achievements of the program." I think we can all agree. And Pedro sent a message recalling Kevin and Carolina staying up all night to watch a lunar eclipse at an astronomy meeting in 2007 in Germany, one of the first events that brought them together. She then moved to South Africa in 2010 as an SKA research fellow at SAO. Here she developed e-tools for research and where she also rediscovered her old interest by winning hacking contests. She then spent almost a year as the Director of Academic Development at Ames for the Next Einstein Initiative. Bruce Bassett said of those first years at Ames, her energy, optimism, and enthusiasm were exactly what we needed, and she immediately had a massive impact on the group. Michelle, who just started her research career when Carolina joined Ames and is now a colleague of ours at UWC, said, Carolina was the first woman astronomer I ever worked with and was a mentor in my formative years. But she was as warm as she was brilliant, and she was more like a big sister to the students she worked with. Carolina then, as she does, switched careers and spent 5 years as a chief scientist at a startup company called Thumbs Up, where she discovered that they'd hired someone with a mix of exceptional talents. As Stafford explained, while whiteboarding on an idea for a short video streaming service, Carolina came up with an architecture idea which is exactly what TikTok looks like today. During this time, she was in the Mail and Guardian top 200 young South Africans and Belan magazine's top 300 most influential people of Switzerland in the under 40s category. In 2018, she joined UWC as Associate Director, Development and Outreach at the Inter-University Institute for Data Intensive Astronomy, IDIA, and as an Associate Professor. She spoke often about how happy she was at UWC and how her perspectives on science, society, education, development, and inclusion seemed to find their natural home at the university. In 2018, she was awarded the International Astronomical Union Special Award for recognition for her pioneering work in the field of astronomy outreach, development, and education. She made the Inspiring 50 list in 2020 for recognition of her being one of the most inspiring women in the country. In 2021, she won the prestigious NSTF Award, also known in South Africa as the Science Oscars, for her role in science communication, for, quote, reshaping how science is communicated to the general public, and in particular, research into building a scientific vocabulary in African languages. She was a founding member of the African Network of Women in Astronomy and has served on their board. Their condolence message reads, she is the embodiment of Nelson Mandela's well-known phrase, it's always impossible until it's done. She's shown us that that is true many times over. Carolina was unbelievably talented at everything she was interested in, and she was interested in almost everything. She always managed to elevate her interest into something higher, something better than what was imagined before. For example, she fell in love with the chameleons near her home in Muizenberg and then started to plan a citizen science project around them. She was an amazing photographer and made one of the first time-lapse videos of a breathing plant. She was a fantastic dancer. And when she discovered Zumba in Leiden, she decided to become a Zumba teacher rather than a student. A faculty member at Leiden remembers meeting her for the first time as she led her Zumba students dancing past his window on a float down the canal. She was at home while talking about science funding in EU meetings with world leaders. She was at home while riding in a village in India on the back of a motorcycle, holding the earth ball for an astronomy workshop. She was at home dealing with the practicalities of carrying a telescope into Gaza to conduct a program with Palestinian children. She was at home everywhere. Carolina was incredibly brave and honest about herself. When she was fighting against cancer, she also thought it important to write about her experiences publicly, talk about her journey, and form communities of solidarity with other cancer patients. True to her nature, she also developed a genuine curiosity about the biology of the disease, and read medical journals and talked to specialists on their own turf. For her, emotional honesty, human empathy, and scientific curiosity were always natural allies, and to see them as distinct human experiences was alien from her worldview. She even gave a TED talk exploring the emotions and love she felt as a mother in the context of both sociology and biochemistry while carrying baby Cyprian in her arms. Carolina was one of those rare individuals who had genuinely brought happiness into the lives of people she met. She was a brilliant mind and a polymath, and like a Renaissance person, saw no distinction between domains of human knowledge. That brilliant mind was always accompanied by kindness and joy, empathy and solidarity. What stays with us is her constant ability in finding beauty in things we have learned to take for granted, in finding science inside nature around us and inside art, in finding art inside technology we use every day, and to be greeted with her smile when she did find them. Once after she left Leiden, there was a lovely sunset, which none of the astronomers were interested in. The shout which got us, Niraj, and colleagues all out of our offices was a colleague going, come, come, don't miss it. It is a Carolina sunset. At the center of her world were Xavier and Cyprian. It was always easy to see how much she loved them and how proud she was of her boys. She always wanted to give them all she had, all her intellect, all her heart, all her skills. In the last weeks of her life, when she knew that the cancer was spreading and that she may not be around to fully do this, her one special wish was for all those who knew her and who knew her different roles to tell the boys about them from many different perspectives and thus help in some way to give them an idea of the marvelous mother that she was and person that she was and what she would have given them. It seems scarcely believable that we have had someone like Carolina in our lives, someone so talented yet so humble and willing to teach, someone who would go out of her way to believe in you and support you so much that you started to believe in yourself, someone who finds beauty and science in everything around her and sees the two as intertwined, someone who cares deeply about other people's suffering and forges her own way of helping, someone who was truly at home and at peace everywhere but had a special love for South Africa, someone who loved her family fiercely and who wanted to help them make a world a better world for her two sons along with Kevin. Someone who we have lost but who has taught us all so much, loved us all so much, and will be with us forever. All she would ask in return is that we pass on that love to others too and to keep her boys in our heart. Her colleague Buzani captures it so well when she says, "Ukaralina ngomtu," which literally translates to "Carolina is human." But the meaning is much deeper and means she represents the best of humanity and is a model of how people ought to be as humans. Another colleague, Sibuyile, expands on this and says, the late Steve Biko always refers to the world with a human face, similar to Pisani's concept. Carolina is Ingelosi Yomhlaba, an angel on earth. And as an African, I believe she lives on as we continue to call her name and remember her. It is usual to end in a eulogy with appropriate quotes from famous authors and poets, but we know that we have our own poet and philosopher in Carolina. So let us end with two quotes in her own words. As we have seen in the past 2 years with the pandemic, it is science that unlocks solutions to the biggest challenges we face, but not without humanity, and that's exactly the nexus of where I get to work. And lastly, I'm so grateful for this life. I've looked at what drives me, and I've realized that I am not driven by insecurities, nor by grudges, greed, fame, nor status. I'm only driven by love for my family, my friends, my colleagues, our students, and it's such an amazing place to be.
Thank you so much, Delia, and for Niraj, who's not here. I'd like to share a message from Carolina's parents and her sister, from Marie, Stan, and Michaela. They say 1,000 words cannot express a proper farewell to you, Carolina. So we just say, thank you for the memories. Our love for you is eternal. Bye, Nina, and au revoir. And now I'd like to hand over to Kevin. Thank you, Kevin.
Thanks very much, everyone. It's my time. This sucks. Really, really, really sucks. And we knew it would suck. We knew it would suck a lot. But the level at which this sucks is far beyond our powers of extrapolation. Gravity feels 10 times stronger. Food has lost its taste. the sky is suddenly a lot less blue. Songs that we love now all speak of death. It feels like all of life's pleasures have been intricately attached to you. And they have all left the planet with you. We have been tortured into a numbness that pervades every aspect of all waking moments. Getting through each day's duties is an emotional marathon. Our hearts are not broken. They're shattered. There's no relief in saying goodbye. There's no relief that we've reached the end of the cancer journey, because you are not here to share it with. There's no relief that all the pain, discomfort, anxiety, dread associated with this disease is over. There's no relief because we actually didn't need any. We took it on together. You, me, and the boys. And we never let it beat us. People are saying you lost the battle. But they don't know. You were never beaten. We were never beaten. No matter how hard it was no match for our love. And I'm not sure people quite appreciated the strength of this love. There were moments when the physical pain was so bad that you would actually bite the duvet in agony. And I would lie helpless next to you, unable to do anything more than to whisper, "I love you," and to bring you more drugs or hot water bottles or whatever I could scramble. And the pain would gradually subside and you would be able to return the "I love you," and we would have won. No, we were never beaten and we never lost. We would have been more than happy to deal with the disease and all its painful effects until we were 80 years old, because our love was more than enough. We were never beaten. Death comes to us all, but we are only beaten when the imminence of our demise or the trajectory towards it robs us of our smiles, our kindness, our humanity. And you never lost your smile. You never lost your kindness. You never lost your humanity. You were never beaten. And you never lost to cancer. This world without you is much darker. But the world with you, whether in person or in memory, is still far, far brighter than any in which you never were. It is only natural that the depth of sadness we feel now has to be at a level deep enough to balance the heights of the love, the joy, the happiness that we shared when you were alive. I selfishly wish that I could see one more smile, that I could have one more chance to make you smile, one more little morning of a note of love from the boys, one more, oh, one more "I love you," one more hug, one more doggy cuddle, one more tear of sheer joy, one more big picture conversation, one more analysis of politics, technology, climate change, or the state of the world, one more ta-da moment when you solve a tech problem, one more inspiring talk, one more song on the piano, one more chat about how grateful we are for this life. But we always knew that there were never going to be enough moments. Even if we did make it to that sunset when we're 80 years old, we would probably have said, this life together was simply not enough. And we would be as grateful then as we must be now, grateful for the moments that we were actually lucky to have. Carolina's final days in hospital We're filled with love. Not just love for our family and friends, both through visits and so many messages, but also love from the nurses, love from the doctors, love from the hospital cleaning staff. As Reggie said the other day, say it in your heart, creep. She crept into everyone's hearts. I'd be sitting at a hospital bedside, and everyone who passed through would just want to comfort her, to help her, to give her love and kindness that she somehow managed to inspire out of people. I got a bit jealous sometimes. I mean, I was there trying to spend time with her, and everyone was like, no, no. Maybe it was all this love. Maybe it was a sheer strength, but Carolina exceeded all the doctor's expectations. There were at least 3 or 4 times during the last hospital stay when everyone was sure she would not make it through the night. And then the morning would come and she would have miraculously bounced back. Even as the cancer spread, and this was an extremely aggressive cancer, she still, in those last days, kept beating the odds in terms of medical expectations and surprising everyone with her sheer strength. I'm told by all the doctors that when she finally passed away, she was on enough drugs to be free of any pain and anxiety. And I keep wanting to ask you how it went, if it was really okay, just to make sure. The one thing I do know for sure, she passed away knowing how much she was loved. Well, to a certain extent. I don't think she had any idea of the immense outpouring of love that she would receive after she left us. But I know she would have been infinitely grateful for it, as I am too. Thank you. Some people may wonder why Carolina chose to be as open as she was about the ups and downs of the cancer journey. Ever the communicator, ever the educator, ever the motivator, she wanted to make people aware of the disease and its effects. She also just wanted to be honest. She did not want to hide anything from the boys or from those she loved. And she loved us all. She knew that what she was going through was not unique. She knew that this could happen, would happen, has happened to anyone, to any of you, to any of those she loved, or even those she never met. And she wanted to show by example that it is still possible to live, to love, to smile, to be kind, no matter how gloomy the situation may be. When things were tough, another chemo session, another hospital stay, another scan, she would just shrug her shoulders and say with a smile, "We dala what we must," and then push through. Of course, we were privileged, you know, and we recognized the privilege that we could afford the medical care, and she always sympathized with those who couldn't, you know, that people go through this who can't be in the private hospital that we were at and get that sort of treatment. There's that famous saying that goes, everybody dies, but not everybody really lives. Well, Carolina lived, and you can too. In fact, she wanted you to. While you are alive and you have the opportunity to create your own legacy each day, you have the opportunity to be kind, to smile, to make someone else happy, to spread love, to be like Carolina, so that when your end comes, you can look back proudly and say that your time on earth was filled with love and kindness. Most importantly, Carolina was always grateful. Grateful for the life she lived, grateful for her boys, for family, for our dog Berlioz, for her work and the people she interacted with, for the understanding employers, for her friends, for all the care she received from hospitals, for the amazing teachers at the boys' school, for our supportive neighbors, grateful for our house, for her plants, for all her tech, for the chameleons on the island, for rainbows, for sunshine, for nature, for the universe. It's hard not to be happy when you are grateful for so much. And when you are happy, you make other people happy. So, my love, let me end. Let me end by saying to you one last time, all the things I kept saying to you in hospital during those last few days, even in those times where I had to be the only one doing all the talking, maybe this time it'll be more coherent. You've been the perfect mother, from carrying the boys inside you to the incredible efforts during childbirth, to your diligent breastfeeding and giving them infinite love that will last throughout their lives. The boys always came first, even before yourself. There will always be more you want to give them, more you can give them. But you've already given them the best foundation ever, and that will make them better than you and I ever could be. You've been a perfect dog mom. I've never known a happier dog. Berlioz knows how much he's loved. He's outside somewhere. The bond between you two has never faltered since you fell in love with each other at the SPCA. And the scrawny pup of unidentifiable breed came home with us. Love is blind. You've been the perfect worker. Everyone loves Carolina, and everyone appreciates working with you. Whether at UNAWE, Thumbs Up, UWC, AFNOA, AFAS, Commission C2, GA 2024, Inspiring 50, so much more. Everyone loves working with you. The many prizes you've won, the colleagues and students you've inspired, the people you've mentored, you can be proud of what you have achieved professionally, and you already have a legacy that will never die. And that eulogy was awesome. Thanks, Delia and Neeruj. You've been the perfect person in every way to everyone around you. Daughter, sister, friend, colleague, mentor, advisor, boss, tech support, teacher, and everything else you were to so many people. For me, you've been the perfect partner. I would not have turned into the person I am without you. All the skills you say I have, all the things you praise me for, it was all because of your love, love we share in this family. We always looked forward to the sunset when we were 80, even long before we were married. Well, I'm going to stick to our plan, and on your 80th birthday, I'll take your ashes to that sunset, and you'll still be with me until then, because I'll be wearing this ring until I die. And when I do die, I've given the boys instructions. I'm going to mix my ashes with yours, and I've now shown them exactly where to lay us down together in our special place. In the last few days, I said this like a mantra over and over again, even when I wasn't sure that she was listening. Thank you, my love. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You've changed the world. The planet is a better place for having had you in it. Well done. We're all so, so proud of you. I'm proud of you. Yeah, everybody loves you. You're surrounded by love from near and far. There's nothing to worry about now. everything will be okay. You can be at peace. We'll be okay eventually. We'll be super sad, of course, but we'll survive. You've made us strong, and you made us resilient. You've prepared us well. You've been so strong for so long. You can rest now. So there's something, you know, with the, there's always something with Carolina, right? She wanted to play a song. So I'm gonna play this song. But she also was very specific. She wanted everyone to understand what the words meant. So you see all around the walls there are these words. On se retrouvera. If you can all take out your phones and Google those words, put the word lyrics after that. Yeah, funeral, I'm asking you to switch on your phones. It has to be Carolina's. So you can share devices and stuff, but just type in those words because it's a French song and... guys, you guys speak French. You don't need to the translation, you can just get the translation on, if you type in, we will meet again, yes. But the translation for all the lyrics, so type the word lyrics after that. Okay, I hope you're ready. I'm using Carolina's phone, Carolina's speaker. She was always prepared, right? I need to figure out how to. So she wanted you all to follow the words. If you don't understand French, then you can see the lyrics in English. On se retrouvera, Francis Lalanne. Let's take a moment.
Thank you.
Don't worry, there's nothing much left for me to say. I'd just like to welcome Nikki to do the word of thanks. And just please also remind you that Carolina will be led out to the acclimation chamber done by Kevin and her boys and the close family. And in the meantime, we invite all friends to join us in the tea room. There's always food. Food brings us together. So there's beautiful food to be prepared. And outside, as we know that Carolina had a deep passion for our planet, we have lots of bubbles to be blown in memory of her. And at 12:30, you're most welcome to join us at their home. So yeah, thank you very much, everyone. And over to you, Nikki. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I think that Carolina would say, this is amazing! So thank you, everyone, for being here this morning. As we're all here today, we can be thankful for such a beautiful gift. She was a gift to all of us. And so through her life, she has left an invaluable part of herself with each one of us here. And so if it had not been for Marie and Sten Ödman, we would not have this beautiful gift. So I want to say thank you to them for blessing us with her and for letting her come to Africa. I'd like to, on behalf of Kevin, Xavier, and Cyprian, say thank you to the following people. If I do omit anyone, please forgive me. A special thanks to Ellen for supporting the family during this time, and also Nuruj, who's been there, to Delia, to Angela, to Lisa, helping with all of this. Thank you very much to Nuha for stepping in and making things happen. Thank you so much. Thank you to those who have brought their blessings this morning. To Reggie Majo, Rose, and Sunny, thank you so much, not just for the prayer, but also for loving Carolina the way that you did. And also to Smarajit Triambok, thank you so much for supporting Carolina's parents this morning. To Siambonga Machuhule for the Kwoza prayer. To Amanda and Jeff. To Michelle Murphy this morning, thank you everyone for bringing your blessings and leaving it with us here this morning. We cannot forget the invaluable help that we've received from the doctors and nurses and cleaning staff at the hospitals, and for the 5 years of good care that they have given our friend, our sister, our colleague. We thank them for that. This morning, we also want to give thanks to FBOB Funeral Home for their help and their support and their service. To the audiovisual team who stepped in with helping us streaming live and all of the equipment this morning. Thank you very much. We also think of those who have left special tributes for Carolina. You can Google and you can just see her. It's just there. You cannot imagine the love that has been given to this woman. The DSI, FS, FNWA, UWC, IDEA, Inspiring 50, all the special tributes. Thank you so much to everyone who has sent a message of condolence and love for the flowers, for the meals, for the hugs. Thank you so, so much. The UWC is arranging a memorial and details will follow. This will happen on the 25th of November, which is next Friday. And lastly, I want to say and take a moment to say to Kevin, Xavier, and to Cyprian. She would have said, my love, thank you so much for sharing her with us. Thank you for sharing your wife, your partner, your mother with us. I emulate these words of the lyrics and I say, you were her strength when she was weak. You were her voice when she couldn't speak. You were her eyes when she couldn't see. You saw the best there was in her. Lifted her up when she couldn't reach. You gave her faith because you believed. She was everything because you loved her. Thank you. Danke in Kosi. Merci beaucoup to everyone.
For those of you who arrived just after 9:30 and who haven't had a chance to view and would like to say your goodbyes and au revoirs to Carolina, please feel free to do so. Berlioz has to say goodbye and the family. To those of you that have said the prayers and the blessings, you are most welcome to join Kevin and the boys and the family as they take her to the aquamation room. You are all considered family if you wish to. And after they've moved through, I think everyone's ready for a Kusa Stearns and some coffee. Please come and help yourself. There's coffee, there's juice, there's water, snacks.